The most effective in this war? The Bido have it, and they control it. So, this is Quattro V, and you are watching Stage 4 of R-Type Final with the ship Leo Number 2. As you can see, green laser power! It is just as good as it has always been, if not better, because you don't have to send your side bits flying around to do anything useful. 5 beams is just ridiculously good. I'm filling the screen up with blue! Come on! So for this stage, we're actually going around in a circle. In the background, we're just passing it, but if you look closely, you can see the silhouette of, well, something. In any case, this is a pretty simple thing we're doing. I have to say, this is probably one of the easier stages. After 3.5, a lot of things seem easy. At least in terms of just ridiculously fidgety, you gotta be in this place, sort of, controlling. But back to the stage. This guy kind of is like Capsilon Light. Once the spikes start coming out, you can start shooting his butt. He's got several segments you gotta destroy, and I can't really tell when I'm doing damage to him. I mean, if your force is touching him, your score counter does go up, but if you're doing damage to him through your lasers, it does not. Which brings me back to the point I made, I think, last stage. I have no idea when I'm damaging things. But the psi bits are excellent. As you have noticed, they clear terrain. They don't even care about terrain. They will just go in there and fuck shit up. Maybe that's why I picked Leo for this stage, and it wasn't just a totally random sort of dealio, but yeah. So, for those of you less familiar with Leo, basically, it was a ship that didn't originally have a force, but by the time Final came around, they gave it one, and then it just went from good to totally overpowered. The Cybits are always firing, as opposed to just in red laser mode, and you can point him forwards and backwards. He's like completely omnidirectional, and I love it. Probably one of the best ships in the game, if I may say so. I'm always kind of experimenting on like how to kill this guy faster, but unfortunately, it looks like this time I kind of forgot to do the second segment. Doesn't matter though. There's a point at which this guy is actually gonna stop, because he can't go any further in the stage. But he still fires, actually. So I'm just focusing on the front part of the head, because I don't want him to be shooting me in the butt while I'm trying to deal with the rest of the enemies. The only time I really know I'm hurting him is when he starts spewing the purple stuff. That is obviously a cue in there. But unfortunately, the front head has a back segment and a front segment, so when you think you've destroyed him, you actually haven't. It's just totally mean. And we just got the red laser, and yeah, fake out, he's still alive. What gets really awful is that the patapatas will actually go through his head and loop back around, even if he's stuck there. So if you basically have the patapatas, you don't even know they're coming, but then they all are, and then you're dead. Otherwise, this is not so much too heavy in the way of surprises. Even if you were to get caught under those panelings, there is no terrain death. I sincerely believe, that even if you don't have invincibility on, you will actually clip through the bottom of the stage and pop back right where you need to be. So, yeah. I'm not sure if I like that, but doesn't matter. It seems silly that you would ever get stuck under there. Red laser is normal, no need to talk about that stuff. Looks like we're heading towards a boss, so I decided to go and charge up my laser, because let's just get the drop on him for once. For once in my life, let us do. The game hates me sometimes. But we are going to the boss fight. This is actually true. Can you guess who? No, it's not a peregrine falcon. It's Dobakeratops. And those power armors that spawn behind you could totally kill you if you were not paying attention. Either way, he's got the same sperms as usual, and the same tail action. You hit the dongly thing, and you go to you kill him, basically. If you're really good, I've done it before, just saying, you can kill him in one shot, one charge shot, with a dongly. Otherwise, it probably takes two. Not too big of a dealy, because this is not difficult. Unlike in Delta, the tail really won't do anything to you that would be threatening. It's very predictable, and it doesn't take up too much screen real estate. That said, the sperm continues to spawn from the head portion, and you need to make sure to take care of it, otherwise it will bite you in the ass in a few seconds. Where the part of the boss that's still pulsating is your next target. So it's live. If you hit it, you'll die. Just saying, I've done it. You take care of the sperm, though, and you can easily maneuver around the head and get back into position. Not that I have done that terribly well. And be ready for phase two, which I do not know what it is called. Not that it matters. Once it starts flashing, obviously you need to damage it. Things you can do to this guy are shoot off his parts before he spits it at you. That is important because the globs move around really unpredictably, and it's not fun trying to dodge them when they move about as fast as your ship. But on normal, I don't know, maybe not on hard, he'll just die outright. Otherwise, he regrows all those parts and you do another cycle. Anyway, next stage is stage 5.0, dimension 26. See you next time, guys. Oh, and by the way, I'll tell you about my high score in the post.